So VidCon exists, and I went there.
And almost died.
And no, I'm not kidding about that. Let me tell you a story. So on the last day of VidCon, I was walking around, getting recognized while walking around, just normal stuff. Though after that, I was gonna meet up with some people, but I had no idea where they were. So I asked through the power of technology, and one of them said they were in Hall D. So I headed on over. When I got there, I realized they were nowhere to be seen. And you wanna know why? Because I was in the hallway of Hall D. Yeah, I'm smart. So I rushed into Hall D and found they were in line for Tim Tam's meetup. The line was too long, so I figured I might as well wait. Once everyone in line for the meetup left, we decided to go to the world's largest inflatable obstacle course. Right when it starts, you have to climb up a wall while using little handles to support you. So it's like a cheap climbing wall. Well, it was also super slippery because of the rubber and stuff, so I slipped while putting my foot into the handle. Luckily, I caught myself while I was falling with my hand, but my foot was stuck. Great, now I'll have to explain to everyone why I'm 10 minutes behind them. Luckily, someone working at the place saw I was stuck and got my foot unstuck. I asked them, hey, can I just leave the obstacle course? And they said, nope, and walked away. Well, this is just great. Fun fact about me, I can run pretty fast, but not for a long time. So I finally completed what I thought was the whole obstacle course, and I turned the corner expecting to see the finish line. But nope, turns out that was only the first section. I still had 3 more sections to go. Ugh. So I dragged my tired body through the course, and eventually I made it to this kind of stepping stone section. Oh, stepping stones, this is easy. But then I realized these were inflatable stepping stones. Now this is where the big thing happened. So the first stepping stone is big, but it has 2 cracks on either side. My exhausted body didn't think much of it, so I stepped onto the first stone and slipped. But instead of just falling into the cushioning inflatable ground, my body managed to squeeze into the little crack. I was stuck. I started shouting for help, but nobody came. I bet nobody could hear me either because the only thing sticking out of the crack was my nose and above. The scary thing about it is that if I happened to fall just a little bit earlier, my whole body would be stuck under there, and no one would realize. I might have also suffocated. Hey kids, you know what suffocation is? If not, it's basically when you can't breathe, like when you're underwater, or you're in a haunted mansion holding your breath so that the evil witch doesn't hear you. Or maybe you're just stuck in an inflatable obstacle course at VidCon. It's painful, and you can die from it. Yeah! But on the bright side, I managed to wiggle myself out and continued the course. At the very end, there's a slide you go down, so my tired body rolled down the slide into the finish line. Dude, what happened? Boy, do I have a story for you. I talked about how my foot got stuck, but not falling into the crack, cause it haunted me at the time. I was feeling really lightheaded, so I was about to sit down when, hey dude, I'm a really big fan of your videos, can I have a picture? Sure. Okay, thanks. Ugh. If that person is watching this video, then they know that I was about to pass out that whole time. They're still really nice though, hi. But I can only imagine going into like the afterworld and when someone asks you, so, how did you die? You'll have to respond with, oh, I got stuck in a crack in an inflatable obstacle course. How about you? But yeah, luckily I'm alive.
Hey guys, hope you enjoyed that video. Thanks to Tyler Rietti for being something. If you guys want to be something, then like the video, subscribe with notifications on, and comment I'm now something. I'll pick one person to be featured in the end card just like him. VidCon was fun. I forgot to say it in my other end card, but I feel like it's fitting for me to talk about it in this one. So yeah, I enjoyed it, and it was cool, and I got to meet a lot of people. Also, you probably noticed that there isn't any fan art. That's because it takes me a long time to do fan art scrolls. So yeah, I'm just featuring one of my favorite fan arts. Also, I feel like I should let you guys know that Rolo died, but until next time, make sure to eat your breakfast, because the most important meal of the day.